Usually if there's a tower crane on the sites that are suited for a tower crane, that is the main lifeline for the whole job site. It's feeding materials to all the subcontractors out there. You can't miss it on the job site. It dominates the visual site itself. My name is Matt Hayden. I'm the Vice President of the Tower Crane Division at Maxim. I've been here 27 years. Tower cranes are used on pretty much any type of job in the U.S. now. Historically, they were predominantly used on mid to high-rise jobs, especially in urban areas. But with the expansion of the range of tower cranes and lifting capacity in more modern tower cranes, you could see a tower crane on a hydroelectric dam, building a bridge, building a high-rise, building a small multifamily apartment complex. Really no limit to what you can do with a tower crane. The lifting capacity for a tower crane can range from as low as 2 tons maximum up to over 100 tons. Our tower crane fleet currently consists of over 300 units. Majority of them are hammerhead cranes in the 300 to 400 ton meter range, which is typically the most popular in North America. The easiest way to know if you need a tower crane is contact a sales rep and let them figure it out for you. Some jobs are going to be more suited to a tower crane versus a crawler, but that's really unique to each site. The support equipment you'd need for a tower crane job ranges from just the over-the-road trucks to haul the loads in and out, to any number of assist cranes, mobile cranes, to erect and dismantle it. I think the most common surprises for customers when running tower cranes is the amount of planning that goes into it ahead of time, whether it's coordinating traffic control to get the crane in and out, it's the engineering of the foundation, maybe engineering of the tiebacks. It's much more of a project than it is just a crane rental.